Welcome back. This is a continuation of learning about testing that can be done to know if you're infertile. There are other testings that can also be done for your fallopian tube. A common one is something called chromotubation. Now, this is a surgical procedure, or it is done in an operating room. This is where we do a laparoscopic surgery, where we go inside your abdomen. We make very tiny incisions to take a look on your internal structures altogether. And during that procedure, we also will instill a dye through the uterus just the same, and we will watch to see if that dye passes through the fallopian tube and gives us answers right away. Now, it's very common that you may have one blocked tube, and sometimes you may have both of your tubes blocked. Now, if your test comes back that both of your tubes are open, wonderful, we've checked something off your box. Another test that we can do is to check for your ovarian reserve. That means checking to see how many eggs you may have left in your ovaries. Now, there's absolutely no way to give you an exact count of how many eggs that you have left. If we did, that would have been pretty marvelous, right? We probably wouldn't be having this conversation. However, there are other ways that we can test. Know that from conception, you have created all the eggs you will ever have in your lifetime. At the point of birth, you may have 1 to 2 million eggs in your ovaries. By the time that you get to the point of puberty, you've gone down to about 25% of that. So somewhere between 400 and 500,000. Now, you're not ovulating and having 400,000 periods in your lifetime. That's because every day you're losing eggs tremendously every day until you get to the point of menopause when all of your eggs are now depleted. This is why timing is essential. Your ovarian reserve is a test that gives an idea of how much eggs you have left. And this can be done in several different ways. My favorite that I like to recommend to my patients is a test called Anti-Mullerian Hormone, or for short, AMH. This is a blood test. It is very easy. It can be done in any laboratory setting. And this blood test will give you an idea of how much active eggs and reserve that you have in your ovaries. With that number, it can guide you. In general, if your result is greater than 1, it says that you have a good ovarian reserve and the likelihood of you getting pregnant by producing an egg on your own is adequate. If that result is less than 1, then we know that you are nearing the end point of having a depletion in your egg reserve. The closer you are to 0 is the closer you are to not having any eggs left behind. That information will guide you with family planning. Another way that we can test for ovarian reserve is with an ultrasound. The ultrasound will look at your ovaries and it will look something like this. It will show you the amount of what is called antral follicle count. That's how many eggs that we can see in activity and maturation preparing for ovulation. In general, a normal antral follicle count is around 12. If that number has reduced significantly to maybe 2 or 3 per ovary, it gives us an idea that your ovarian reserve is becoming low. Another test is a Clomiphene citrate challenge. And this is where we give you Clomiphene, which you may be familiar with as Clomid. And depending on how your provider provides this testing for you, if it works, then it means that your ovarian reserve is normal. And if it doesn't, your ovarian reserve might be low. The last recommendation here, or testing that can be done to let you know if you're infertile or not, is check in your partner. I say this because oftentimes when we think about infertility, it becomes a female problem in our minds, but really it is 50-50 male as it is female. So while you're getting testing or while you're talking to your doctor about possible testing, be sure that your partner is also seeing a doctor. They can get a semen analysis, which is a very important test to be sure that the sperm that your male partner is producing are adequate and up to par. That means that there's enough of them there, that they're moving accordingly, and that they are carrying all the genetic information that they should. I hope that these testings and everything we talked about today was of value to you. I have an offer for you today that is completely free. If you click that link below in the description area, you will get access to my ebook on hormone balancing. With this information, there is a ton of guidance on what's happening hormonally in our reproductive systems and lots of information to learn. Join me and thank you for being here today.